director of music. Welcome in this space. The sun is shining, the birds are chirping, and it's almost springtime. So I'm glad that we're here together. Also, thank you to everyone that is watching online today. Your presence is known to us, and thank you for that. I have two announcements I'd like to lift up. The first, our chancel choir is in need of some more committed singers on a weekly basis. If you are interested in helping us out, we do rehearse Thursday evenings at 6 p.m. downstairs in the fellowship hall. Also, we have a great opportunity to collaborate with our Henderson Community Chorus as we prepare to sing the Foyer's Requiem on Sunday, May the 1st. Sunday, May 1st at 3 o'clock in the afternoon here in this space. If you want to join us, we rehearse Thursday evenings as well at 6:45 here in the sanctuary. I hope to see you there. Today's prelude is titled, Os Tifonot, Out of the Depths I Cry to You. I think of this as more of an angst or a prayer to God. We, in the worldly things, get lost sometimes when we think God is not present, but He is so present, especially in this space. I encourage you, as you listen this morning, you'll hear a repeated melody theme in the pedal and in the hands build up each verse, and it comes to a crashing end at the very end of the piece. And this is to represent that God is our sustainer. Listen now to these words from Psalm 130, verses 1 through 5. Out of the depths I have cried to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. If you, Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with you, that you may be feared. I wait for the Lord, O my soul waits. Let's be inspired and worship Christ this morning.
Jim Wofford. I am the senior pastor here at First United Methodist Church. It's so good to have you with us today. Let us join together in the responsive call to worship as we call out to our Lord and Savior this day. Ashes have been smeared, sins confessed, and a journey begun.
We come to follow and faithful Lord.
These times, they are troubling.
We come to follow and faithful Lord.
It is God who sustains, not the temptations of this world.
We come to follow and faithful Lord.
In the Lord is our trust, our protection from harm. Jesus, the Anointed One, brings life renewed. So, Lord, come quickly. Lead us now by your Spirit. Let us stand as we sing together hymn number 172, My Jesus, I Love.
Thank you. I'm David Latham. I'm a retired United Methodist minister and teacher of our open door class. It's my privilege to be able to pray with you this morning. Let us pray.
Oh Lord,
who established all of creation out of love, and with love, and for love, we praise your name above all names and call you, Lord, a name to be honored and respected. And yet so often, we use it with disrespect, sometimes to curse or for humor. Hollywood uses it for dramatic effect or for a laugh, thus choosing profit over respect. Like everything in our lives, we are always having to choose. To choose what and who is first, and often, Lord, we have to admit, you are not first. Forgive us. For we don't know what we are doing because we don't know who our true Lord is. How we live reveals who our God is, and many times it is not you. We see in the horrible war of Ukraine that your name is invoked for protection, not for guidance, or Russia would not have invaded Ukraine. It was and is guns, tanks, and missiles, and bombs, and threat, and empty speech that is guiding, and not negotiation, and the search for peace, and the preservation of life and goodness that leads the way. We pray for the Holy Spirit to find her way into Mr. Putin's heart, to steer him away from greed and evil intentions, overcome whatever is feeding this conflict. May the winds of peace and civility catch hold and the evil of domination and cruelty die a quick death. We pray for the people of Ukraine and all who now reside in fear in Europe. May your Holy Spirit seize the force of terror and silence it. May the Holy Spirit rise up in the hearts of the Russian soldiers who know what they are doing is not right and strengthen their resistance. Let there be peace. We give you thanks for the power of goodness that is being revealed in many nations and many persons who are reaching out to those who are fleeing, to those remaining. Proceed through the holy period of Lent, aware of the call to repentance and renewal. May we respond to this call and find a new wave of fresh living within our reach, that we may live with you as our Lord. We pray for those we are personally concerned about. Those we don't even know, such as the Russians and Ukrainians, and for those on our church's prayer list, for homebound members, military personnel, and veterans, for first responders, for Barbara Sapp and her family, for Chloe Burke, Kayla Hansen, Lee Walters, Larry Buckley and Caitlin Raleigh, for Kathy Kemp and her brother's family, the family of Ron Olney. Please, O Lord, attend to their needs. We close this prayer praying as Jesus taught us, our Father, which art in heaven. Hallowed be.
oftentimes in our giving. And so at the end of the service, you would be placing your offering in the place at the back door, as well as online. You can give through our website, and just invite you to come by the church if you want and connect with us that way as well. But you'll see how each week we very often try to put in a way in which your offerings make a difference. And this is that time of year in which those that are going into the ministry go before boards, have their progress tracked and examined, and there are those who serve as local pastors that come in, and that's one of the advantages of having a connection with church, where we have opportunities to encourage folks that are oftentimes feeling very much alone in their work as a pastor. So we have these different boards and committees that help that to happen. And I want to thank you for your giving that helps that to occur, that our ministry, encouragement goes well beyond just the pastors here on staff, the directors of the different ministries, but actually extends out into our district across the state. So thank you very much. And so with that, let us continue in our worship as we